فلقيت بهم دابة أهلت كثير الشعر لا يدرون ما قبله من دبره من كثرة الشعر.
At the time of sunset, when they entered this island, they met a beast. This beast had so much hair on its body that he says we could not distinguish its front from its back. We did not know which is its face and which is its back because of the amount of hair this beast had on its body. On seeing this beast, we asked, "Waylak ma anta? Who are you?" He replied, "Ana al-jassasa," that I am a spy. This beast then said, "In taliku ila hadha ar-rajul fi ad-dir, fa innahu ila khabarikum bil aswaq." This beast then said, "Go to this man in the monastery. This man in the monastery is eager to know about you. He is waiting for you and he is waiting to take the information you bring." Hazrat Tamim al-Dari radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, "Lamma sammat lana rajulan farikna minha an takuna shaytana." That when this beast told us to go to this person in the monastery, we began to fear this beast, lest this be the shaytan, the devil himself. فَانْطَلَكْنَا صِرَاعًا. Tamim al-Dari radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, we hurriedly went on until we entered the monastery. فَإِذَنْ فِيهَا أَعْظَمُ إِنسَانٍ رَأَيْنَاهُ قَطُّ خَلْكًا وَأَشَدُّهُ وَثَاقَةً مَجْمُوعَةً يَدَهُ إِلَىٰ أُنُقِهِ مَا بَيْنَ رُكْبَتَيْهِ إِلَىٰ كَعْبَيْهِ بِالْحَدِيدِ. When we entered the monastery, we saw a big-bodied man. Never have we seen this man before in our lives. And never have we seen such a man in our lives. This man was firmly tied up. His hands were tied to his neck, and his knees and the area between his knees and his ankles were firmly tied with chains. On seeing this man, we asked, "Ma anta? Who are you?" The man replied, "Soon you will come to know who I am. Soon you will come to know about me. But first tell me who you are and where have you come from?" Hazrat Tamim al-Dari radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, we told this man that we were Arabs. And we told this man how we got to this remote island. And we told this man about the beast that we met, and that the beast directed us to you in this monastery. Now this man, he began to ask him questions. And at the same time, he began to tell him things that were going to happen in the future. He asked this group of people from Lahm and Judham, "أخبروني النخل بيتان." Tell me of the date trees of بيتان. هل تسمح? Do the date trees of بيتان yield fruit? Do they bear fruit? We replied, "Yes, the date trees of بيتان yield fruit." He said, "Soon a time will come when the date trees of بيتان will no longer yield fruit. No longer will they bear fruit." He asked, "أخبروني عن بحيرة طبرية." Tell me about Lake Tibariz. هل فيها ماء? Is there any water inside this lake? We replied, "The lake is full of water." He said, "Soon a time will come when this lake is empty. Its water will disappear and the lake will be dry and not a single drop of water within this lake. That time will come soon." He asked, "أخبروني عن عين زغر." Tell me about the fountain of Zughara. هل في العين ماء؟ وهل أهلها يزرع بماء العين؟ Is there any water inside this fountain? And do inhabitants irrigate with this water? We replied, the fountain is full of water and its inhabitants irrigate with this water. He said, soon a time will come when the fountain of Zughara will have no water inside it, and thus its inhabitants will not be able to irrigate with this water. He asked, أخبروني النبي الأميين. Tell me about the prophet of the illiterate. ما فعل? What does this prophet do? We informed him that the prophet of the illiterate has emerged and he has left Makkah al-Mukarramah and migrated to Madinah al-Munawwara. He asked, أقاتله الأرب? Do the Arabs, have the Arabs fought with this prophet? We replied, the Arabs have fought with this prophet. كيف صنع بهم يا? How was he treated? The Arabs. We replied, he has overcome the people within his neighborhood, and they have submitted themselves before him. He said, it is best for these people that they should obey this prophet. وَإِنِّي مُخْبِرُكُمْ عَنِّي أَنَّ الْمَسِيحِ. He then told these people about himself. He says, now I'm going to tell you about myself. I am the Masih. I am the Dajjal. And I am waiting for my time to appear. And soon Allah will order me to appear. My time to appear on the face of this earth will come very soon. And once I appear, I will travel the world. And I will cause fitna and destruction in every city, every village and every town, except for Makkah al-Mukarramah and al-Madinah al-Munawwara. As these two places, Makkah and Medina, are haram on me. I have no permission and I cannot enter these places. If I try to enter these places, angels with swords in their hands will chase me away. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after he narrated this hadith to the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, said, Ala, hal kuntu haddathukum? O Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, did I not also tell you a story like this? About the Dajjal before Tamim al-Dari radiallahu ta'ala an, the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in replied, Ya Rasulullah, you also gave us an account on the Dajjal like this before Tamim al-Dari radiallahu ta'ala an. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam pointed towards the east. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the Dajjal is in the east. So my brothers, the Dajjal at this very moment exists. And he is waiting for his time to appear on the face of this earth and cause fitna. And that time is very soon. The majority of the minor signs of Qiyamah have already appeared before our very own eyes. But how will the believers at the time recognize the Dajjal? How will we know that this place, this person claiming to be the Dajjal, is the Dajjal, the real Dajjal, the one the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and every other prophet has warned his ummah and nation of? Is it true that he has an eye in the middle of his head as is known to the people? When will he appear on the face of the earth?